Now, this is the time to welcome the facilitator, I mean the speakers. And please, as I said, the session is recorded. I think Chris had already clicked recording. Please, not so. Yeah, what I want to remind you, which I forgot to mention, is that the session is going to run for 30 minutes presentation, 10 minutes questions and answers, and then 10 minutes to move on, change over to the next room for another presentation. So this session is going to be presented by two people, that is Toma Ray and Arafin Happy Mim, both from Bangladesh. The topic is young midwives leading quality improvement in Bangladesh. These two people are young midwife leaders. Arafin is 23 years and Toma is 25. And Arafin works in currently in a government health facility in a research and training management institute in Bangladesh. And Toma Ray works in a humanitarian crisis area in Rohingya at a refugee camp. Now, they are both executive members of Midwives Association in Bangladesh, and they recently graduated from an international leadership fellowship development program with Nursing Now Challenge in the UK. So they are, as I said, they are both executive members of the Bangladesh Midwife Society. In 2022, they were credited with using quality improvement methodology to help their midwife associations recruit and retain its members. And they also help develop guidance on responding to various types of emergencies in Bangladesh. So we welcome Toma Ray and Arafin Happy Mim to take us through their research to see what exactly they achieved as young midwife leaders in Bangladesh. So Toma and Arafin, I will make you presenters.
Here we go. The board members of executive of Bangladesh Midwifery Society. In Bangladesh, midwifery is a new profession, and here first midwives graduated in 2016, and they're working in government sector since 2018. So 2,557 midwives have been deployed in government sector, plus 400 midwives are working in the humanitarian sector. So in this regard, with aim to provide midwives with the necessary knowledge and skills and adequate equipment to enable them to carry out their work and leadership, Bangladesh Midwifery Society was formed in 2010 as voice all of the midwives in Bangladesh by nurses. So our first election was in 2018 with some midwives elected then, and in 2021 election resulted in all midwives leading the society. So all of us are young with no experience in leading an organization, and therefore the YML program and Nursing Now fellowship program were very, very important for us. Here you can see the diagram of ICM professional framework. It's very important to have a professional framework or a structure to support it, strengthen it, and guide its development. And the ICM professional framework for midwifery acts as an informative and guiding tool for ICM, its members, partners, and stakeholders. And we are so proud that as a midwifery association, Bangladesh Midwifery Society is also a member of ICM. So here you can see the 10 comprehensive components of ICM professional framework, and association is also included. So it is very important for midwives to belong to their professional associations to have a strong collective voice, especially in a country like Bangladesh where midwifery is totally new. Midwives associations are examples of women lead civil society organizations that can improve gender equality and access to sexual and reproductive health rights, and acts and agents for the profession. So they have potential to impact its elements of the ICM's professional framework for midwifery. We are two of many young midwives in Bangladesh who are stepping up to lead our midwives association. So to advocate for midwifery services and for an enabling environment for the midwives, this is improving gender equality and access to sexual and reproductive health rights in Bangladesh, thus addressing the sustainable development goals. Here we try to give a visual look of leadership in Bangladesh, showing the different aspects. And to help us lead our association, we took part in 1 year leadership development program with Nursing Now Challenge Fellowship Program. And here we learned about leading ourselves, leading others, and leading organizations. We also learned how to lead quality improvement initiatives also. So this was important because across the world, there is a gender gap in healthcare leadership. 75% of nurses and midwives are women, but 25% leadership positions are taken by women. So also in our country, in Bangladesh, there is discrimination against people who are young, and our culture and our health services can be hierarchical. People are giving respect here because of their age and years in service rather than competence. So we have just midwife position and some temporary positions in government sector in Bangladesh. In this regard, education is also important part, because without higher degree, it's much difficult. Overall, as young midwife, young people, we have to learn how to be confident leaders and need to make a strong environment for us to show our leadership. Here you can see the whole image of education and opportunities in Bangladesh. Each of us had to identify a problem. Here we draw the leadership program, and that we what we learned through the leadership program and the philosophy and methodology. The process taught through a combination of theory through lectures and practice through the implementation of a quality improvement project. The leadership theory was the theory program was run by the University of Global Health Equity in Rwanda. There were 61 participants from 8 different countries in Asia and Africa. We were 2 of 5 participants from Bangladesh, and the quality improvement part of the program was led by the Ubora Health Institute in Ghana. Quality improvement improvement and leadership linked was together there. So we need strong leaders for successful quality improvement initiatives. So the whole program was a mix of theory and practice also.
Testing.
We attended lectures online and had to work in groups. We also formed a small group of the 5 YMLs in Bangladesh to encourage each other, and we were each supported by a mentor from the UK through our twinning partnership with the Royal College of Midwives. So here each of us had to identify a problem and design a quality improvement program to address that problem. Here we highlight the tools taught during the program. As we are both leaders of the Bangladesh Midwifery Society, we wanted our work to benefit the association. So we asked help from the president, staff, and executive team of Bangladesh Midwifery Society to identify problem that Bangladesh Midwifery Society was facing. So one problem was that, like many midwife associations around the world, Bangladesh Midwifery Society also struggles to recruit and retain its members. So we also want to have a strong link with the midwifery education education institutions and recruit student midwives as members. So I focused my quality improvement project on this issue. And our another problem was that Bangladesh is a country prone emergency and humanitarian situations. So we have geographical vulnerability, both of floods and cyclones. And also because of our proximity to Myanmar, where there has been ethnic cleansing of Rohingya minority group. Right now, Bangladesh houses almost 1 million Rohingya refugees in an area of the country called Cox's Bazar. And this is the world's largest refugee camp. And there are also frequent industrial accidents and fires in Bangladesh. As the Midwifery Society, we wanted to have clear guidance about how to respond to a crisis and what is our role as the professional association for midwives. This was the problem that my co-presenter chose to focus on. So under the quality improvement process, we were taught a process for quality improvement with 9 steps. And these are identify a problem to work on. Second, problem identification and problem analysis process, and set aim statement, and then make activity plan to give result, and develop change ideas to test, balance measures to the measure aim, complete PDSA cycle, and describe activities with data and document. And the last one was plan for the next cycle of testing the idea to learn more about the impact of the change idea. We found it quite difficult to apply the QI methodology to our own individual projects, because most people were doing clinical quality improvement in their hospitals or health centers. We were looking to improve services by the Professional Midwives Association. And it was hard to see how the quality improvement methodology fitted with our objectives. So however, our mentors from UK helped us to see how the methodology could apply to our projects. So under my membership project, we set some activity plan with different activities. So in this regard, we needed to set some meetings and aim or to achieve the goals. We set some meetings with the project manager of Bangladesh Midwifery Society, because we had a small budget to complete the whole project. First of all, we draft a project plan and make a budget to review benefits provided by Bangladesh Midwifery Society. And we also set some meetings with our data consultant to have knowledge about Bangladesh Midwifery Society membership status. We also set some meetings with our membership subcommittee. Like in our association, we have some subcommittee individually, like membership subcommittee, funding subcommittee, and the advocacy subcommittee. So with this meeting, so we set some activities, what to do in advocacy program, and how to communicate with the students to engage them as a member of Bangladesh Midwifery Society. We also did some meetings with the student leaders here to help students to make a strong leadership profile in institutions also as students, and they help other students to enroll in e-learning platform. We also did some advocacy program under the project. We advocate teachers and students about the association, that is Bangladesh Midwifery Society, and its activities and opportunities. And we also take feedback from them about the care and quality provided by the Bangladesh Midwifery Society. So under membership project, we in our membership project, our outcome indicators and measurements were increase in number of student members of Bangladesh Midwifery Society, and our target was 500 more student midwives. We compared the student numbers before and after the quality improvement project. The second one is number of institutes to engage with Bangladesh Midwifery Society. And due to very short budget, our target was 13 institutes, but our positive reach could be 165. The third one is a percentage of students accessing the online platform. As Bangladesh Midwifery Society, in collaboration with WCEA, is providing all members with access to a mobile app and online CPD training platform. So we have 113 courses through WCEA mobile application and 122 online courses in our e-learning platform. So our target was 60% of 500 students accessing the platform. That was 300 students access the platform. And the last one was to draft a mechanism BMS can identify and support students with their specific issues. In this regard, we did one survey with some specific question. So to draw a visual face of the problems that, and issues that our members were facing, and the result was to have a good idea about our provider services. Here you can see some picture from our membership project. As we said that we did some advocacy program in institutions. So this is a private institute called Institute of Child and Mother Health in Bangladesh, advocating teachers and students to make them engage with Bangladesh Midwifery Society actively. And we also influence students in this regard. And we also introduce the e-learning platform of Bangladesh Midwifery Society to the students and teachers. This is another picture from Dhaka Nursing College, as the Dhaka Nursing College as a central nursing institute. So this college is a role model to the others. In this session, leadership principles were broadly introduced with the intention of engaging more student members. Another picture from Tura Catholic Nursing Institute, and during the advocacy program, students and teachers got to know about the association and its activities, its opportunities, and they also got to know how they can use the e-learning platform of Bangladesh Midwifery Society and how they can be a member of the association, explained briefly. So we also explained how an association can help to grow midwifery profession and how they can be engaged with it. So from now, the another project on emergency response has started. So I give handover to my co-presenter to carry on. Thank you.
Thank you, Arafin Mim. I am from the emergency response project, and I focus the emergency response issue. As you can see the background of emergency response, I use there the five that what, who, why, where, and when the problem was, and here is the emergency background and question to the five-wise question I described to my whole project. Bangladesh is an emergency prone area, so the emergency situation including flood, cyclone, and influx of refugees, women, adolescent, and children are particularly vulnerable in emergency situation, and at risk of gender-based and other kind of violence. One in our four people affected by humanitarian crisis are women and girls of reproductive age who require access to and reproductive health service, and more than half of the maternal death occurs in emergency setting. So through a quality improvement project, Bangladesh Midwifery Society try to help the midwives and the mother during emergencies. For that, the Bangladesh Midwifery Society must be clear about its role in emergency preparedness, response, and mitigation to ensure that women and their families continue to receive high-quality sexual, reproductive, maternal, newborn, and adolescent healthcare during emergency situation. 2018, Bangladesh Midwifery Society commissioned a consultant to develop of a strategy for its role in emergency. Since then, midwifery has become more established in Bangladesh, and it's need to update the emergency guidance now. So here is you can see the emergency response project, and that I include my aim, methods, and theme from data collection. So as the Midwifery Association, Bangladesh Midwifery Society was not clear about its role in emergency situation. So what is the role of Bangladesh Midwifery Society during emergency situation? How can Bangladesh Midwifery Society help the general member during emergencies? And how can the member contact with the Bangladesh Midwifery Society in emergencies? These are the main motive in my project. So the aim of my project was by January 2023, the Bangladesh Midwifery Society will have an up-to-date policy on its emergency situation that will have been tested, reviewed, and adopted by the Bangladesh Midwifery Society executive team and will have been disseminated to the member and the stakeholder. And you can see the main theme from my data collection that midwife and Bangladesh Midwifery Society must be involved in national and local emergency planning. Bangladesh Midwifery Society can access member needs, provide support, and advocate for high quality SRS service by midwives in emergency situation. And also Bangladesh Midwifery Society can provide education for member on their role in emergencies. So this is this slide is including the emergency guidance draft. Now up to date position paper has been developed by me with the cooperation from the Royal College of Midwife and the wider Bangladesh Midwifery team, and following specific stakeholders' engagement. So this is recruitment through my project. Here you can see the emergency new draft guidance. So it is include the emergency preparedness, emergency response, and resilience. So for emergency response, Bangladesh Midwifery Society should participate in national, divisional, and local emergency preparedness network and a forum to raise awareness of maternal health vulnerabilities. Should offer training to member on emergency response and develop rapid assessment tool for use by local teams. They should also anticipate needs of member and have supplies and funds available to enable immediate response, access, and reserve fund for use in an emergency. For emergency response, Bangladesh Midwifery Society should collect data from member in the emergency affected area using situation background assessment recommendation tool. Escalate SBAR finding to divisional coordination and policy level stakeholder, and they also continue to collect data from member throughout the emergencies. They also engage with national and divisional response team and provide fund or equipment if available to member according to their needs. Also monitoring health and well-being of member in affected areas. And for resilience, Bangladesh Midwifery Society advocate for National Midwifery Education Program to be prepared midwife for their emergencies and also follow up on action point. And this is the picture that I conduct a session in RTMI College in Sylhet that it is an emergency, Sylhet is an emergency prone area, and every year the time more of the emergency situation happen there. So through this response project, I met there with some midwives who are affected during emergencies, and they shared their stories how they suffered with the pregnant mother during an emergency. I also shared the emergency draft guidelines with them that when they affected an emergency, they can contact with BMS during emergency situation. So these are the lesson that we learned from the from our quality improvement project. That this quality improvement project, we had to draft a project plan and budget. And it was all about how we can utilize that short budget with different activities by making proper activity plan with the knowledge of leadership skill and learn through the classes. We are able to make a strong group of students, help to engage our student as a member of Bangladesh Midwifery Society and register midwife. Help us to form a focus group by which we are also able to take knowledge about necessary steps. We are also able to contact different stakeholders who are already engaged with emergency situation. And it was also a leadership development process which we learned through our project. And we did also advocacy program and face-to-face program, online program. We also include leadership mantras with the students to make their leadership base strong as a student. Please go through the next. So this is our last from the World Leadership Development Project, and that here we learn in the form of team meeting, brainstorming session or forum, and where a team member can discuss challenges, share insights, and several key steps to systematically identify, analyze, and address areas of. Hello? Sorry?
Can you just summarize one or two and then we ask and give comments?
Okay. So we also learn how to develop service quality in our workplace, how to use the knowledge and data collection and monitor effectiveness and to grow strongly. So this is our opinion that can help the other member who were include leadership development project. Thank you. So please go through. So this is our summary experience that that we explained here, that our quality improvement project taught us how to improve the system, help us to achieve predictable result, and healthcare system and organization, and help us to identify potential areas in improvement. So data collection and analysis, monitoring the effectiveness changes also, and our experience from this quality improvement project was full of knowledge. It was the first quality improvement project we did, and it helped us to grow and make a strong leader. So beside the methods we learn, it helped us even in our work by making our midwifery service qualityful. Every midwife should engage themselves with quality improvement project, especially where midwifery profession need and strong leader and qualityful service. But for that, we need to more opportunities, more platform, and express our circumstances. Go to the next slide, okay. Please.
Ara, your time is up. Any comments and questions?
Okay, Margaret. So our final thought was practice the philosophy of continuous improvement. Get a little bit better every single day. Here are our references, and thank you so much. We want to thank the organizers of VIDM to make this fabulous platform for this opportunity. So we can go through the question and answer session if anyone have any question to ask. And thank you so much for the comment, ma'am. And the question is, what advice would you give to other young midwives who want to raise their voices, how to have confidence when you are a young leader? So I think if anyone want to raise their voices, I think it was quite difficult if you were individual, that we learn from our quality improvement project, that through an organization or teamwork, you can raise your voice, because in such of country where midwifery profession is totally new or needs some new opportunities or need to raise their voices in different sectors, need to establish gender equality, then you will need a strong association. So I think every midwife should be engaged with their professional association, and to have confidence as a young midwife leader, you should involve yourself with different sectors, with different stakeholders, and obviously the quality improvement project as the opportunity, it will help us to grow a more strong leader. Thank you.
Okay. Any other comment before we wind up? We have only 3 minutes to leave this to change over to conference room A?
So, Margaret, we have another question. Like, what was your experience of older, either medical or public professionals? Did you object to be you being too young? No, we don't have any object to being too young because as our profession is totally new in our country, we are proud of that. At this short age, we are representing our country and our midwifery profession in different sector. So I think it's a matter of feeling proud. So thank you for your question.
Okay, from what I've learned is that for young leaders to succeed in their profession, it calls for building their leadership, also involving themselves in these associations and partnerships with others so that they are really coming out from project. And again, partnership is key in the success of any project. For example, the role of all the stakeholders have to be well highlighted. Each person knows the roles they have to play in any project. And Ara and Toma, I wonder how you really deal with the patriarchal issues in Bangladesh, being young leaders in midwifery, and you say midwifery is a recent profession. I really wonder how you deal with the patriarchal societal perceptions in Bangladesh so that you can be able to move through your project.
So I think some cases young midwife may need to success lead quality improvement initiative in Bangladesh. That is the strong leadership and communication skill to inspire and motivation the midwives also. And it is also include analytical and problem solving skill to identify and gaps in the healthcare system, and it also include, it can be the knowledge of evidence-based practice. We can also practice it and quality improvement methodologies to develop and implement effective intervention. So handle that kind of system in Bangladesh.
Time is up. Thank you so much, Ara and Toma, for this presentation. We wish you all the best in your leadership development as you move forward. Thank you. Chris, do you have any comments?